to you at work. Call in and join the fun toll free at 1-800-889-0267 right now. So sit back and let's start the lunch break. Les, Dawn, and Freddie S. are ready to go. So here are the boys from Brooklyn and Dawn.
South Florida, Atlanta, New York City. You know something?
What?
I'm way off today.
Are you? Well, let me tell you something about why I played that song.
What is that song?
I was walking in your footsteps by the police because exactly a year, what am I saying? I wish it was a year ago. 33 years ago today on this date and day, Friday, October 23rd, 1983, was my first ever concert, and that was the police.
You've had an unbelievable memory.
I thought you were going to say you were arrested by the police.
But I can't remember what I did last Tuesday, so, you know, it's bad. It's the short-term memory that's going. It's going any minute now.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Yeah, you take over.
Welcome to our Friday Brooklyn Cafe.
Yep. I can't do it.
We are having a...
What's wrong with him?
A catch-all. He's still recovering from last night.
Oh, that was something last night.
We had an event last night. Hopefully, right now, you can see us on live stream. Yes. Amp2 TV Productions. We are also live streaming. We should be on Two Boys from Brooklyn. Are we on Periscope, perhaps?
Yes, we are.
At Two Boys from Brooklyn. Periscope at Amp2 TV. We are on Instagram, hashtag Two Boys from Brooklyn. And we are on Twitter, hashtag Two Boys from Brooklyn.
What happened to Spotlight?
And you can listen to us on 1230 AM. WBZT.
I thought Spotlight was supposed to be here.
Well, funny thing. Okay. We did have Spotlight Media coming, but every time this one guest is booked through Spotlight Media, he has another deal. So apparently the guy we had who created this amazing app is now being invested by an amazing company for $10 million.
Oh, good Lord.
Today. Happens today. So his $10 million investment came through today, an hour before he was coming on air. So... I don't know. He chose the $10 million Russian investor over coming here.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's okay. We're going to put you on camera today.
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Because no, if no. I got to be on, you got to be on.
This is your show. This is not my show.
This is our show.
It's our show. Okay. And you were part of our show last night.
That's right. You were tremendous help.
Tremendous help.
Becky and Boca. What was that called? Becky and Boca?
Becky and Boca Spotlight on Style event last night at Clive Daniels Furniture Store in Boca.
That was
unbelievable.
Heavy.
Talk about heavy hitters there. Those were your East Boca heavy hitters if I had ever seen them.
Oh, yeah?
Big time.
I was rubbing elbows with heavy hitters.
You are rubbing elbows with those heavy hitters at East Boca. Yes.
Listen.
Flows.
Why do I have like 13 messages from you and Becky? And then I have a picture of some.
Do you like that picture?
Holy smokes. What is that?
That's the skirt they want me to go over to Serendipity and perhaps
purchase. You remember the lady that we had on? She had a real short skirt at the end with the blonde
leather,
hair.
The leather fringe?
Yes.
She's a meteorologist in Tampa.
Oh, wow.
She was the one that was supposed to call in.
During the hurricane.
During the hurricane. So you see how that happened. She blew away.
Oh, well, it happened.
We had the pom-pom girls on yesterday, which
don't
was
start.
Hysterical.
Don't start. I'm going to start laughing.
Becky had hand injections being done. There were facial injections. There was purline injection and lip injections going on. Clothing. And you do know what? There was a bathing suit fashion show.
Yes.
And if I can tell you... Freddie, I don't know how you missed this, but there were some women walking around in bathing suits made of chains.
Yeah.
At one point, I did look over, and the top was just like lacy chains.
Yeah, I saw that
right?
One.
Did you see that?
I didn't see that.
Yeah, I know you didn't see. You were busy doing our other stuff, where we were overly clothed compared to the bathing suit fashion show.
Yeah, well.
If you thought my dress and that little fringe was nothing, you should have seen the bathing suits.
I saw.
That Dylan was emceeing that fashion show.
Of course he was.
Of course he was.
And then when I told Dylan, why don't you come over here and get on the set? With Becky and Boca, I can't. I gotta go do that over there.
I heard him.
I gotta go do the bathing suits. Oh, they have bathing suits?
Hello.
Yeah.
I didn't see no bathing suits.
Yes, you did. We were talking about one.
Bathing suits?
That one lady that was walking around.
Is that what that woman was wearing?
I told you that.
I thought that was her dress.
No.
That was a cover-up. A bathing suit cover-up.
That was a cover-up. I told you that.
Can I be honest?
You know why?
I'm afraid for you to be
honest. Can I be honest?
We had a few drinks.
There was an amazing bar, music by Arturo Romei.
Time out.
David Rosenberg diamonds. Did you see that diamond bib Becky had on?
Time.
Ooh, yeah.
Can I be honest?
I'm afraid. That's why I'm kind of trying to divert the conversation from your honesty. Have you noticed? I'm deflecting.
I didn't know that was a beanie, so first of all, so my apologies.
I told you it was.
What did you
but
think
But some
it
people
was?
Should not put on bikinis. I'm sorry.
Hey, man, if he
Everyone's
were a...
body is beautiful.
Everybody's body is beautiful, except that train wreck.
I said, no,
I
she was
I didn't
fine.
See.
She was
I didn't
fine.
See.
She was a little older, but she still had the body to wear it. She was thin enough to wear it.
I give her kudos for attempting
Let me tell you something. If you were a chick, you would be such a...
And you wonder why we have issues.
Well, wait a minute. Was I wrong?
I didn't see her. I don't know.
I thought she was... I gave her all kinds of credit because I wish I could walk around like that. And
honey, I gotta tell you something. But if she walked around like that, you can walk around like that.
The What's makeup the and the beauty that was in that room last night.
Yeah.
The diamond. Oh, my... We have David Rosenberg coming on the end of November.
Is it true that David sold some heavy-duty earrings?
He sold some heavy-duty earrings. Yes,
Did you see that? He sold them there.
No, I didn't.
I don't know which earrings he sold.
I know which earrings he sold.
You do?
Because everybody came over to tell me. And I was like, okay.
That
and
bib David, was beautiful, though.
That bib was magnificent.
What, the spider
bib?
Thing?
Yeah.
How much was that?
I don't even
250,000
know.
250,000 of these?
That probably was more.
Probably.
More?
Probably. Those yellow diamonds?
Easily.
I love yellow diamonds. Oh, my gosh. It was like a spider bib of diamonds. And then at the end of each one was a big yellow diamond pear.
Yeah.
Teardrop. Oh, my gosh.
The only problem I have with something like that is, where do you wear something like that?
To the Becky Boak like that. Event. That's it. She's already planning the next one.
So was that an event for her? Did she create this event?
She created that event.
That's her radio show.
I know that.
She's so funny. She says, I do it for amusement.
No, the funny thing is that people came over yesterday.
Yes.
And they're talking to me about they're on... What do you call it? Inter what? Intergalaxy? What is it? On the website. On the internet radio.
Internet radio. Internet radio.
It's called something else. Interglacier or intergalaxy. I don't know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know either.
Terrestrial radio?
That's it.
Terrestrial radio.
What is terrestrial radio?
We're on terrestrial. We're not satellite radio. We're terrestrial radio.
We're like E.T.?
We're not extraterrestrial.
Wait a minute.
We're here.
So I asked her. What station you with? Oh, no, I'm on the internet. That's not terrestrial.
I don't know. All I know is that we are terrestrial because we are not satellite. If we were satellite, you'd be paying a premium.
I see what you're saying. Okay.
Yeah.
So this lady's come over, right? And I was sitting with Faith. Faith?
Faith Washington, yes.
Faith is a very funny person,
Faith's
by the way.
Faith's hysterical.
And she's telling them, why don't you come to the major leagues? I was dying. The people were like, what? Major leagues.
There was this cute little couple, and they were littler than me.
So, really?
Shorter?
Ain't nobody littler than you.
Shorter than I am. Cute little. They said, I don't understand what's going on here. So we explained. So where would I find you? Do you have some information you can write down for me so I can keep finding you? It was really cute.
Aww.
And then I realized at the end of the night I never quite got around to giving them that information. Because Becky had all these interviews, we had to keep going.
You did a great job.
Oh, thank you.
You did an excellent job.
Running around.
You did
I should have put on my running shoes. Who knew I was doing that in a gold lamé dress and high heels?
It was amazing. and all the furniture. I fell in love with all the furniture there and all the tchotchkes.
It was a beautiful event.
I loved it. Can we talk about
your dress for a second?
What would you like to talk
about?
That
was a bow. That wasn't a dress. That was a bow.
I was wearing a gold lamé bow.
It was a ribbon.
It goes with the wrap it up.
It's a ribbon.
Yes.
Imagine what I can wear here
ribbon
for Christmas.
In your hair.
It's about the size of it.
Pretty much.
It was about the size of a ribbon you would wear in your hair.
But you know, with all that beauty there, I was not intimidated. I was like, that's who I am. Okay, this is who I am. I had no idea I was coming to this, so here I am working.
Did you have fun?
Everyone was having fun.
Well, I had a great time because I kept us hydrated with the sparkling wine. I didn't get drunk. It takes a lot now, but it was fun going back and forth, and then I got us some snacks. And it was fun watching and talking to Dr. Amy and just hanging out. And
yeah, Dr. Amy loves hanging with you.
It was great.
It was a great
time.
Event. We had Dr. Virginia Crist. Remember, we had her on the show, so she was by visiting. Renee, the senior advocacy lady, was there.
Renee was there. She had on that black and white dress. Amazing dress. I couldn't recognize
it. A lot of great dresses last night.
Where do I know
you? Did you notice a lot of the people there you knew from our show?
No.
You know, it was like a reunion. I'm walking around thinking this is a reunion of two boys from Brooklyn.
Aww.
Because all of our guests were there.
That was pretty cool.
We had Becky. We had Lisa from Serendipity. Renee was there.
Them two, I know.
We had Dr. Amy was there. Dr. Wacky was there.
Dr. Wacky. That's not her name.
This way we don't identify really is. Well, now I can't say it because people will know her. Oh. But she knows who she is.
She was so funny.
My very best friend who's a little worried about me.
Yeah, she's very worried about
me. But it was a great event.
It really was. And it was, for me, it was last minute, so I had no idea what I was going into.
Thank you so much for stepping up. We would have never been on air without Connecticut.
Oh, it was easy. I mean, all he told me to do was plug this in, push that button, do this and that was it.
Gio, you would be proud of your father. He did a good job.
He did a great job.
We are not on Twitter.
We're not on Twitter.
You're not on Twitter?
We're not on Twitter. We're not on Periscope.
No, because I'm supposed to do something and I didn't realize. All right. No, we're not on Periscope, but we are on Days of Our Lives.
Well, I'm glad at 12:17 you're now joining the show. Welcome.
There's so much stuff. So much stuff. Did you see all the stuff you have to do a production?
Yes. I've been in those productions
before. I mean, you're used to that.
Yeah.
There's more.
I know.
Stuff, but I don't
want to. Listen, when I go to a show, I would love, everyone would love to be the star, or the singer, or the guitar player, or whatever. But I envy, my mouth waters. I watch the guys behind the scenes. I watch the person at the board. I watch the lighting guy. That's for me, that makes me happy and excited. I would love to do that and tour and be on tour and be busy and just be crazy and tired. And I think it's great.
Well, I have a guest coming on in November. She's an amazing...
November. That's like next week.
It's next week. An amazing DJ that I'm having her come because she's an amazing DJ, but I also want you to meet her because maybe you guys can work some stuff out together.
You never know.
Who's that, Boomy?
Boomy.
Boomy.
Boomy. Yeah. DJ Boomy?
Yes.
DJ Boomy.
That's cute.
Yes, she's awesome and she's very women empowered and spiritual and meditative and creative.
I like
that. So I want to get you guys hooked up.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You never know.
And Gio just hooked us up. We're on Twitter.
Live. Thanks, Gio.
Yay, thanks, Gio.
We're doing great.
So you can see.
Is he feeling better? Are you feeling? Is he feeling better?
No, he's broken out in hives.
Oh, right. He ate something.
Yeah, he's like a giant
Think he ate something.
No? A little stress?
No, he thinks it's a detergent of where he sleeps. They changed the detergent.
Gotcha.
That's a sleep on the floor.
I'm itching just thinking of it. You see, as soon as you said that, I start itching.
Psychosomatic.
Oh, stop that. It's like when your kids say they've got head lice and you go home and you start going like this.
Yes, it's true.
All right, so hold on a second. I want to talk about...
Oh, we're still talking about my dress.
Your dress.
Yes.
Let's talk about that for a second.
Let's
talk about
it. What about
it? Where'd you get that dress?
I got that dress in Delray.
She made it. I'm just kidding.
She made it.
Sometimes,
what was that dress made of?
Lamé.
Gold lamé stretch. Spandex.
Do you know that?
Yes, it's lamé. You know the material.
I don't know what lamé is from Lamont.
It's like when you look at tulle, you know it's tulle. You know something's velvet. You know it's lamé.
So there was this designer dress that I saw in Delaware. You know Delaware has these very creative designers, and they spotlight in different stores.
Yes.
So I tried it on. There's not much to that dress, and my husband said, "You need to buy it."
Oh my!
No.
But that was very cool.
So we left the store. You know, they say you have to have something when you need, you know, you go back. And that whole night he kept saying, "We really have to go back and get you that dress." Well, who am I to refuse new clothes?
Right.
I said, "All right, we got to go back and get the dress."
It was beautiful.
So there you go.
So you went back and got it?
Yes.
It hugged in all the right places.
It hugged in all the right places. And where it didn't hug, double stick tape, ladies, is your best friend.
That's the other thing. She comes and says,
I have double stick tape.
Yes.
I'm like,
I got painter's
tape. What is she
going to
tape? There's not much dress.
You got to tape it so when you bend over.
Yes.
Because I was working.
You couldn't bend over in that dress.
I was working. I had to do what I had to do. You got to tape the girls in.
You remember the famous J-Lo dress, the green one?
Yes.
I think it was Yves Saint Laurent. Was that Yves Saint Laurent?
I don't think it was.
Anyway, it doesn't matter. That famous dress, that she was holding that together.
Fashion tape. Yes.
Yeah, man. That's a very famous dress.
You don't have daughters. Although, I guess it's not a thing your daughter would share with the dad.
Yeah.
However.
Interesting.
Beauty hack. Yes.
Total.
But we had some great shows. Becky did a great show. Lisa from Serendipity did a beautiful show.
We pulled it off.
You guys were great.
Everybody was great.
It is Friday.
There was a lot.
Funky Friday.
The most stressful part for me was the unloading, and then once we did everything and plugged everything in, it was good to go. And then he left me there for about 45 minutes, and people were coming up to me. Do you know how to turn on a microphone? Do you know this and that? I'm like, yes, I do. Oh my God, you're the best. Like, it was just an on-off switch, but okay.
Did they sound like that, too?
They did.
They probably did.
They said, do you know how to turn on a microphone? It's a really nice one. I said, oh, yeah.
As opposed to a not nice one.
Right, because it was Bose. It's Bose. It's really good. I'm like, I know. I get it. How do I make it louder? It's called a volume right here, the volume knob.
You know what? I can't figure out how to turn the television on in my house. So you all laugh, but I would probably be the one who says to you, how do you turn on the microphone? Why do you find that so amusing?
But I don't know much. Hold on. I don't know much because then the same woman came to me and she said, why isn't my picture on Facebook? And I said, I don't know anything about Facebook because I'm not on Facebook. So after all the accolades of you're the best and you know everything.
She said, you suck.
Probably.
She wanted to be live streaming. See, that was what happened. Is you turn the lights on. Did you see the guy actually walk through the set?
Yes.
Yes.
And did you see? He walked through the set and then he tried to come back the other way.
He walked through the set.
And whistled.
And people kept walking right in front of the cameras. I don't get the disconnect.
They don't care. I don't know what they... Maybe they think we're pretending.
They're walking with their heads down. So I tap to the guy, I go, yo! He looks at me. I go, you don't see what's going on here?
Oh. Yeah.
This is something.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. And all he's doing is giving me the O word. I said, get the hell out.
Yeah, I was trying to avoid all the Botox, because I hate needles. I hate needles. And
I was going to send you over, but you ain't got a wrinkle on your face.
I do. And I look over to my... left, and I'm like, oh my god, there's like a whole crowd of people, and they're all there's somebody's getting injected. I gotta calm down. I need something to drink, so I went and got more. La-da-la.
Did you notice they only served white wine?
Yes.
What was for the furniture?
The furniture.
I think we were having Prosecco all night.
There was Prosecco. There was champagne. There was white wine.
Everything was white.
Sparkling wine. It's Prosecco. If it isn't champagne, which has to come from the region of Champagne in France, it's Prosecco. It's sparkling wine.
So we have
wine.
Prosecco?
So yes. Here's my mother, Grandma Vodka. Why does it always come back to drinking? Her new thing is she drinks Prosecco. Why? Because she can drink the whole bottle herself.
It's true.
Because the bottle is smaller.
What happened to the vodka?
She does that too. But you know, sometimes
what happens when you
places only
vodka?
Serve beer and wine.
Yeah.
So she can get Prosecco, but she can have the whole bottle.
But what happens when you miss Prosecco and vodka?
I don't know. Maybe
Provoca?
She should call him. We can ask her.
And then I got us some Pinot Grigio.
After. I didn't like that.
Yeah, I prefer the Prosecco.
I noticed Dawn was drinking the Grigio.
Dawn doesn't really know what. And then I started sharing a glass with Lisa.
Yeah, I noticed you started sharing your glass with everybody on the set.
But they all got mixed up.
And then I started cleaning up because that's what I do.
Yeah, what was that?
I get like that. I get like, oh no, it's like too nice, and it's my father. My father did that to me.
We've got wires and lights and cameras and boxes, and you start cleaning up the wine.
I just put them all together. I didn't throw them out.
I didn't realize that was part of our deal, but I guess we had to clean up, and so they all cleaned up.
No, we didn't have to do that.
We didn't have to.
We didn't, but it wasn't as if there was a cleaning group that was there cleaning up.
True.
But I was impressed because we got done in a half hour, right? We were just waiting for the carts.
Yeah.
And then they brought us 12 cards, you notice that?
Yes.
It was a great night.
It was a great night.
Becky, you did a fabulous job.
She did. And it's really funny because we're going to have to give them Radio TV 101.
Uh-huh. It's just basic stuff.
Yeah,
look at
it's
this
just
camera.
Basic. Look at the camera and
meanwhile,
talk to the mics.
I found out this morning only one camera was working.
It was a decoy.
And I said, would you have told me which one to look at? He says, no.
You know, this is why I don't tell Dawn anything, Dawn. You're not supposed to say that on the air.
What's that?
That was Dawn. An industry secret.
It's an industry secret. You don't say that on the air.
You guys did a beautiful
Both
job.
Both cameras were working.
Both cameras are working except on me.
Gosh.
Because that's why I kept saying to you, look at this one, look at this one.
Yeah, you were looking at the wrong
and
camera.
And then we kept saying, look at this one. So everyone's looking at the cameras. They seem both working. And you were able to zoom in and out on the clothes.
Uh-huh.
You did a beautiful job on that.
Thank you.
But what about that lady that had that Indian thing?
That was
the
a
red
beautiful dress.
Silk dress.
That was an Indian.
That red silk dress with the fringes, that was horse hair
horse
at the bottom.
Hair. It was beautiful,
horse?
Yes.
And there was Indian on the top?
That was my favorite dress of the night.
That was a beautiful. I believe that was a YSL silk gown.
Oh, that was YSL?
She said that was a two. I don't know if that was such a two. I'll try it on today and let you know.
It was
a serendipity?
That would be two people. If I were 6 feet tall, it would be
First of
two.
All, you can't wear that dress. You're too short.
Exactly. I would end up cutting all the beautiful bottom off.
It's gorgeous.
Second of all,
though,
she used to be a model.
Ah, that's so why she carried herself so beautifully.
So she says to me, I used to be a model, but I'm all dried up now. That's what she said.
Okay.
So I said, you want wine?
Moisturize. I don't know.
That's what she told me.
There were some men there, but not many.
No, not many.
Men. Were there?
Yeah.
No, I saw more women than men.
They were the doctor, they were the husbands, but other than that, there weren't men just there.
There were more men there than at the woman's expo.
Obviously, because it wasn't a woman's empowerment thing, but come on. It was amazing. It was pretty cool. Like, I thought, oh, here we go. I'm going to feel like I'm awful. But I think the way I handled myself, that I'm like, I'm just here to work.
You handled yourself beautifully and professionally.
Yeah, everybody wanted you to fix their Facebook.
I know.
Did you see everyone was sitting with you?
No, not everyone.
Dr. You were congregating Amy, on the couch.
You had a whole sofa to yourself.
Oh, I could have had my own show.
Yeah, you could.
We're going to call it the Carol Show.
Now, you know, it's funny because everybody that I spoke about this event to, I told them we were going to Clyde Daniels. And by the way, Lino Harmon's family does furniture business with the owner, the daughter.
Wow.
I was supposed to drop some names, but I didn't know have anybody to drop them to. But anyway. So when I tell everybody it's Clyde Daniels, the furniture store, everybody laughs at me. Well, who does a show
right.
from a furniture store?
They can do it at galleries. Why not at a beautiful furniture store? Why not?
But my goodness gracious, the way she put this thing together, she had apparently bikinis, she had clothes, she had
purses,
and
flower
and
arrangements,
music and flowers and
massages.
And the vein thing guy,
dermatology.
Was there. She had over $2 million in jewels in the house.
It's amazing.
Did you see his bodyguards?
I didn't.
They didn't look like bodyguards though, but
they
were.
They were hitting on the sides.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Were they? They had to have been with us.
Should have seen what they were carrying.
Really?
I didn't see any. That's good because they were hidden in plain sight. I guess they're like the Secret Service.
I met his wife. We were talking, and she said, "Two broads from Boca. I know two broads from Boca. All my friends are talking about that around town."
Aw,
like, great. Okay, that's
awesome.
My other broad sitting over there.
That was awesome. It was fun.
It was an entertaining evening.
I have to stop eating because no one ever eats. No one eats in that building. No,
but nobody eats.
The women do not eat.
Where'd the food go?
The men.
Food did they have?
Thank God. Connecticut brought me a huge dish of cheese and fruits.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. But do you know everybody started eating off that thing?
Did they? I started eating.
Dr. Amy.
Oh, you shared your food.
Wacky.
He shared from his plate of food.
I looked over.
No.
I looked over and there was less food. And then I catch Amy. That's just it. So she bites into it, puts the other half down.
Get out of here.
So I said, Doc, can you take the rest with you?
What ran out quickly was the prosciutto wrapped around cheese.
That was gone.
I'm getting hungry.
That was way gone. I saw those. I'm like, those are going to be so gone. And it was the men eating that.
I thought about getting food and then it was a fleeting moment. It was a fleeting thought.
See? Because that's what you do. That's how you know you ate. Out. You think about food, and I can't think about food. I will go and seek food, but it was great.
The food thing didn't work for me last night.
No, it was
great. They had a guy that was doing flowers, and he had bowls of candy. So he goes, everybody eat candy. Everybody eat candy.
Bowls of candy.
Yeah,
bowls.
You didn't see the bowls of candy. They're
you
huge.
Didn't see
the Halloween candy.
Yeah, Halloween candy.
So next week, Becky has two of the New Jersey Housewives on her show.
Amazing.
From New Jersey, yeah.
Not from Atlanta, from New Jersey. Hence the name, the New Jersey Housewives.
She has Icky and somebody else.
So we're going to be cleaning up the other studio.
Yeah. Ah. Good luck with that.
We're going to stage it.
You're going to stage it on Mars.
Wow, at NN? You're going to be staging that
Becky's
place?
Becky's going to take care of staging it.
Holy moly. Good luck.
I don't know what that means.
Could she do it the day before?
Not to say...
We'll talk to her.
Yeah, let's do that because I don't know what she has in mind.
I don't know. Well, we need to chit-chat. We need to do some staging.
Well, I would like to change the look at the other station.
We know what we need to start with. We need to clean the bathroom. Basics. Dr. Amy says, I'll come and clean the bathroom. And I said, no more. You are the agenda. You are not cleaning the bathroom.
Not touching that.
Cleaning the bathroom?
The feeling that you're walking into a dentist's office, that has to change too.
We need to just brighten it up. We need to bokeify it.
And then the signage has been around since the Carter administration, so they need to change that. They need to update
All right,
that.
Don't be.
Do you know what?
Don't be dissing.
We've got two bras from Boca. We've got Serendipity and Becky from Boca. We need to. Female Boca eyes.
There you go.
Studio.
There you go.
We need to make it our own. Rabbi Jenny.
And for being in Boca, Rabbi, it should feel like I'm in Boca.
It needs to feel like I am in Boca.
Yes.
I matter. I am the agenda.
Not Rabbi like I'm Jenny. In South Jersey, honestly.
Rabbi Jenny just texted me. She has free time. She's going over to Serendipity.
All right.
Fabulous. Rabbi Jenny, make sure you tell Lisa hello.
Hello. What were you telling us? That there's a special or something?
She's having a sale.
Today only?
Today and tomorrow.
Oh, I may go tomorrow.
She's having clothing 30 to 70% off.
Holy moly.
And she's having her Hermes bag. Some of them are on sale.
I want to look at the jewelry.
I got breaking news.
Breaking news.
Breaking news. Dan, thank you. Don Mansfield from Beasley.
Beasley.
We are going FM on Wednesday.
Wow, it's finally happening.
95.3, we will be FM.
Your show will go on FM
95.3. Big news.
Congratulations.
No more 1470?
Yes, 1470 mm-hmm. and no, 95.3.
Both.
It's WWNN-FM.
Wow.
So
how about that for those call letters?
Wednesday.
One more thing for me to remember. Between the pipes. It's getting a little cloggy up there.
Yeah, you got a lot of clog in your pipes.
And with that note, do you want to do a break?
Sure, that'd be fabulous.
Yeah, should we call the good doctor?
It's up to you.
Let's call the good doctor.
Yeah, let's call the good doctor.
I'll do that.
All right.
Thanks. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back after this section. Wait a minute. I got to get this thing up. All right, here we go.
Please welcome a new sponsor to the show. It's AMP2 TV, the first and only internet network that's truly plugged in. When you're looking for a full-service internet television production company, discover AMP2 TV, a full-service production company that can provide all streaming videos in-studio or remotely. They offer web page development, and they use all the latest platforms to help make your business selling points more powerful. They can do remotes and live streaming, as well as tape productions. Let AMP2 TV handle all of your television production needs. Choose from a variety of creative TV and radio packages and see why AMP2 TV works with many major companies, including Comcast, Bravo, and Fox 29, as well as individuals and businesses of all types and sizes. To see samples of their work or to find out more, visit their website at amp2.tv. That's amp2.tv. Or call them at 1-866-224-5422. That's 866-224-5422.
Have you ever had a business idea that you thought would be a great solution to tough challenges in today's world, but have no idea how to get started? You don't want to waste investment money on ideas that just don't work. Introducing Health and Wealth Seminars, a sophisticated advertising agency with over 40 years in the ad business. What makes Health and Wealth different from other agencies is they fit your product into the public's need. They help put together the strategy of your business before you commit thousands of dollars and just find out those ideas just don't work. Health and Wealth Seminars carry advertising contracts, radio and television contracts, and even a production service contract that will cover all of your business needs. Call today, 954-303-9563, and let Health and Wealth Seminars carry your business to the next level. The number is 954-303-9563. And remember that what happens when you don't advertise is nothing. 954-303-9563 is the number you need to get your business started in the right direction.
Hi, it's Leah, here to tell you about Dr. Anthony Pinozzo. He's a pain specialist located in Southern Palm Beach County, so if you are somebody that you know is suffering in pain, Dr. Pinozzo is the one you guys need to call. And make that call today, because living in pain is no way to go through life. Dr. Pinozzo has been in practice now for more than 49 years. He's treated more than 73,000 patients for pain. He's an expert when it comes to diagnosing the pain, and he has had huge turnarounds. In fact, people with living with scoliosis, he has had nearly a 100% turnaround. Lumbar pain as well. If you've got lower back pain, if you're suffering with migraines or flat feet pain, maybe pain in your elbows, your neck, your shoulders, Dr. Pinozzo can help you. And the greatest thing is, he can help you without drugs, without surgery, and without having to go through weeks and months of rehabilitation. Give him a call today. Set up an appointment. It's 561-381-5800. Tune into his show Sundays, 11 to noon.
Know your body. Gain control of your health. Transform your life. If your body could talk, what would it tell you? At DexaFit, they show you how to take control of your health and fitness to live a happier, more fulfilling life. Since 2011, DexaFit has measured thousands of clients' body composition and fitness performance levels across the country. hormones, metabolic health, and cardio fitness all play a significant role in your energy levels, your sleep quality, and overall well-being. With their proven methods of measure, track, and discover, they show you how your body composition, cardio fitness, and metabolic health compare to your optimal level. They make sure you're continuing to make progress and follow the best nutrition and fitness plans for your body type. At DexaFit, the goal is to help you identify and understand the health and fitness of how to transform your body to meet your individual goals, break through your plateaus, and take the guesswork out. Improve your energy level, sleep, and weight. Discover what's holding you back. Call 561-923-8833. DexaFit is conveniently located at 2499 Glades Road in Boca Raton. For more information, contact them at boca@dexafit.com or schedule an appointment online at dexafit.com. Identify your health risks and optimize longevity and fitness. Call 561-923-8833 and mention this ad for special pricing.
Is your child's tablet time greater than engaged activity time? Are you seeking better wellness strategies for your family? Do you want to redefine what your family's quality time looks like? At New Dawn Health Solutions, we focus on the four pillars of health coaching: lifestyle, exercise, attitude, and nutrition, to create a balanced approach to wellness. Together, we will open the conversation with you and your children on ways to empower healthy eating, increase physical activity, and set goals. Let's talk about the issues that are important to your family's health. Give New Dawn Health Solutions a call at 561-901-2854 or email us at dawn@newdawnhealthsolutions.com.
You're lunching with two boys from Brooklyn who invite you to advertise on the show. Share your good news. Just call 866-224-5422 and get all the information. There are plenty of options, and this could be a great chance to get the word out about your business or service. That's 866-224-5422. Now let's get back to those two boys from Brooklyn.
And we are back. Happy Friday afternoon. I think we have Dr. P on the phone. Dr. P, how you doing?
I'm doing terrific.
You having a good week?
I'm so busy. I can't keep up.
That's How amazing. You doing? We are good. It's Friday.
Yeah, TGIF to you too.
You know, I was thinking of you. I was watching a story on the news yesterday about all the young kids that are really hurting their elbows from pitching in baseball.
Oh yeah.
And having the surgery. Some at 17, 18. There was an 11-year-old who they were deciding whether he needed the surgery, and the parents were sort of in that contemplative state of bracing versus surgery and going forward, what his life was going to be like.
The parents got to get a life. You know, they cannot operate a teenager like that. They ruin their career. They ruin their life. They'll never get that back. Scar tissue is inexorable. It's always there and gets worse and worse and worse. These kids are finished with any kind of sport.
So you can help these kids instead of doing the Tommy Johns, right?
Absolutely. Tommy John is nothing. It should not be done. Just like the ACL, there's no such thing.
So, amazing.
Right, Freddie?
Right, Freddie. Yeah, you were top of my mind yesterday when I was watching these kids, and everyone's jaw was on the floor thinking they're just so young, and look what they're doing.
One of my kids pitches for the Philadelphia Phillies, or used to. His career's over. He had the Tommy John. They gave him a medical out, and he's done. A shame.
Yep. It's a shame.
Yeah, they're going to give him a few bucks a month on a disability, and he's finished.
It's true.
And that's no career. I mean.
It's Friday.
We're trying
that
hard. The knee surgeries are bad too because they end up with scar tissue, and these people have failures of the treatment. So as good as the surgery is, it's what happens afterwards.
You are correct.
That is really painful, and we deal with that. That's the kind of work we do.
It's the scar tissue.
So if anybody's out there and has had a surgery on their knees and has a knee pain, we could take care of that.
And today is Friday, which means you can watch Dr. Pinozzo on Channel 19 U-verse.
Channel 19 U-verse or Dr. Pinozzo TV. Correct?
It's Pinozzo.tv.
Pinozzo.tv. You've got all of the shows, I hear. You've got all of your platforms on your website.
Yes, he does. And it's 6 to 6:30. And if you have AT&T Uverse and you don't pick up Dr. Pinozzo, call your carrier, because sometimes Channel 19 moves around, I guess.
Oh, really?
they float around?
I don't know.
You got to be kidding.
I don't know. I don't know why. He says he has somebody who has Uverse and they can't see him. So I don't know. That makes no sense. But You can go to Pinozo.tv.
Pinozo.tv and see everything tonight from 6 to 6:30. And Sunday, you are on with the boys.
That's right. 11 to 12 on 94.3, our sister station, and 1230 WBZT. 11 to 12 is Dr. Pinozo. All right, big guy.
Have a wonderful Friday.
I will. You too.
We'll
bye-bye.
See you Sunday. Bye-bye.
561-381-5800.
This half of our show, this segment of our show, sponsored by Dr. Anthony Pinozo.
Mr.
Dr. Needles.
Needles.
Dr. Needles. So, yes, I was watching that yesterday, and I thought of him and just these kids, and I thought of you and all your years of baseball coaching, and what are we doing to our kids?
Do you know?
Probably not, but let's try.
That the Oakland A's, the Athletics of Oakland baseball, professional baseball team.
Yes.
Signed a kid in junior high school. Check this out. He's a catcher, pitcher, because he throws hard.
Junior high, they signed him? Wow.
And what they did with this kid is they put in his contract. Now, he's a minor, so his parents have to sign this. Mm-hmm. He goes to college. They pay for it. And there is no law that covers junior high school.
Wow. Because they're minors.
So all of a sudden, they found a loophole. So now the Cincinnati Reds signed the second high school kid. Yeah. And what happens is when you start signing kids this young, puts in a tremendous amount of pressure. They don't get the monies until they graduate college. That's it. That's the kickback here. But
really?
They're good enough at that age. So I was talking to Dr. Amy, your co-host on Two Broads. And she tells me that her
son,
12-year-old, is pitching towards high school seniors. So I want to see this.
You should go out and watch.
I'm going
to
do that.
You should go out and watch. But what are we doing to our kids? Because if you keep thinking the amount of pressure, forget emotional pressure, pressure on their arm, the stress of what they need to do to keep going forward, are they even kids? At 12 years old, come on.
I mean, it's a scary thought.
You've done this. How many kids have you worked with doing this?
I did. I worked with kids who were 9. I worked with kids who were 12, up to 21, 22. But think about it this way. When you sign that kid at 12 years of age, these are the parents saying, wow, I got me a gold mine here.
That's it.
And you better look down the line, because when you have 8-10 years of that training, you know, a baseball player practices for 10 months a year.
It's a lot of stress.
A lot.
Let's let them be kids. That's my belief. Let your kids be kids. It's hard enough to be a kid now with social media and pressures and, oh my gosh.
But they're going to have super children. These athletes, football players that weigh 340 pounds, can run a 4.3. I mean, that's a train coming at you.
Wow.
I don't care what equipment you develop. When you get hit by something like that, you go to the next county.
And then you got to call Dr. P again.
And then you're in a lot of pain.
You're in a lot of pain.
Speed can kill, as they say. But anyway.
I know.
So we had a great week.
We had a fabulous week. Time to relax, getting ready for Halloween on Monday. I see they're having a big Halloween costume event here.
Yes, they are on Monday.
Are you coming in costume?
No.
Phantom of the Opera. I'm coming in costume.
No. Maybe I put on makeup.
I'm coming as the great fairy.
I'm going to come as a woman.
You know, we were at a meeting the other day, and he says, I'll bet you. I go, I'll bet you we'll change clothes for the day. And the guy who we're meeting with, he said, that bet I want to see. He goes, I want to see Freddie. I was wearing that pink top. I want to see Freddie in your pink top.
Oh, my.
He said, that bet I'll be a part of.
He wants me to dress up like a girl. I could put on a wig.
Are we blinking? We have a call.
We're blinking.
I could put on a wig and high heel shoes. I can come in as a woman.
That would be fun.
For who?
Our listeners wouldn't have the joy of seeing you.
Now listen, we can't do meatball Monday because we have to program the machinery.
We're gonna go talk to him.
Yeah, but the machinery does work because we tried it yesterday, so we're all good to go.
We're gonna have fun. We're gonna get it going. Ah, hey Aaron.
Hey Mom.
How you doing?
Hey Mom.
Doing good. How are you doing?
That was nice. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
What's going on?
Yeah, to listen to you guys talk about Halloween costumes.
Oh, you had a great Halloween costume you sent us last night. He sent us a picture. It's movie quality.
It was movie quality.
What is it?
Explain your costume.
I was a Jedi.
Oh.
Oh.
And I took a bed sheet and I cut it up and turned it into a Jedi robe, and it was elite.
Wow.
And you had your lightsaber with you, too.
Well, send obviously, I had my lightsaber with me. I'm not traveling anywhere without my lightsaber.
Send it to me. I'll put it up on the screen. The future of America.
The future of America.
Future of America. And what were you doing last night? Were you working on your law school personal statement? Like, I was cutting up a bed sheet for a Halloween party.
There you go. You're so funny. Yes, you did.
Thank you.
You had fun at the party, though?
Yeah.
Awesome.
How's your day going? How's everybody doing?
Everyone is doing great. Erin is the queen of Halloween costumes.
The queen?
King.
Yeah. I was going to say.
King of Halloween costumes.
You just outed him.
Somebody slipped in.
Always.
She just outed really, her son.
It's offensive.
Sorry, bud.
I know. I think your son
the
is
king
ready
of Halloween.
For his own show.
I think so, too.
He's got a good voice.
He's
got a good
so
voice.
Cool, yeah. See that delivery?
Oh, we're
yeah.
talking about doing a show, actually, at Hillel. They want to start doing a live stream show.
Oh, you told me
that's
about
so, that's so funny, because I'm at Hillel right now with Adam. He but doesn't realize that I'm on the radio, and he wants to start a radio show.
We should
tell
say
him
hi
you'll
to
be
Adam.
The, you'll be the host.
Start a podcast.
Yeah.
A podcast
can,
is really
we can
easy.
Do a whole stream
no,
from Hillel, and you guys
podcast.
Can do a show.
We do video. We don't podcast.
Sorry. A video stream.
We'll send the equipment there, and you set up a studio, and we'll do it remotely.
We'll do a Halloween show.
From Hillel? I don't know if you could do a Halloween show from Hillel, but we could do another show from Hillel.
And the show will be called Erin's Queen of Costumes.
Erin's Queen of Costumes. At least you're a good sport about it.
You know what? That's all I can do because other people might be listening to this. So.
There you go.
Funny.
All right, we're going to get your picture on air.
Yes, we are.
All right, say hi to Adam. We'll get that hooked up for you guys so you can start live streaming your own show right from there.
Okay.
And inspire others.
That's what we want to do.
Have a great weekend.
All right.
Thanks.
Give me a call when the show ends, Mom.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Give us a call at 800-889-0267 to share your stories.
And Gio, don't call me if you need money, because that's usually what ends up happening.
That's probably why he called.
Probably.
He just didn't say it on air.
Yeah.
But the check is in the bank, bud. Yeah, I gotta love that.
Awesome.
College.
That's awesome.
It's so funny, right?
Yeah. It kind of felt like, we got to talk later, and it kind of felt like, yeah, I hear money rustling.
Money rustling. Yeah, I put that check in yesterday.
Awesome.
You know, you're so funny.
Why?
Because you text me his picture.
Did you say send it to me?
I said email it to me.
You said send.
You did say send.
Thank you.
You
did say
it.
And I assumed it was texting.
I was wondering why if I texted. I thought we were just going to blow it up and I can put it in front of the camera.
Let me see if I can.
Make it very simple that way.
Yeah.
Yes, he goes movie quality.
Movie quality.
But I love that he still has his lightsabers from home when he was a little boy.
Aww.
You know, boys and their toys.
Yeah, man.
What do they say? Those with the most toys win?
The one who dies with the most toys
right.
wins, yeah.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? The guys who collect cars and electronics and all that stuff. Watches.
Yes. He who dies with the most toys wins. That's it.
Right?
To
That's what I think.
To the victor go the spoils, yeah.
What do we get as women?
I don't know. A bum deal. I have no idea.
What do we collect?
Shoes.
Consumables is really what my life comes down to.
Shoes, purses.
Consumables.
I like a lot of jewelry. I like a lot of costume and fun jewelry. I'm an Etsy girl, so therefore.
There was a woman there yesterday, another Dawn. There were four Dawns at this event last night.
It's
By
true.
The fourth Dawn, I said, your name really isn't Dawn. She looked at me. She said, what do you mean? Is your name Dawn? I said, yes, there are four of us.
Wow.
So we took a Dawn picture.
Aww.
But one of them creates jewelry. And she said, I have a story I need to tell you of why I create jewelry. I said, share your story. She said, we need to sit down.
Oh.
I said, okay. She says, but we don't have time for my story right now. So I'm going to call you, and I want to come on air, and I want to tell you my story
about
a family tragedy that I turned into something positive, which
good.
Is why I do what I do.
Wow.
Who is this?
Another Dawn.
I hope she's on Etsy.
There.
I'll buy stuff off of her if she's on
Another
Etsy.
Another Dawn. She does crystal jewelry, so I need to get with her and find out what her story is.
Bring her on the show. If not this show, then your broad show.
You know, we have coming on next week, 3 days, co-hosting with us. Sarah.
Yeah, that's right. She said, I'll see you November 1st.
November 1st. Sarah Spiritual will be here Tuesday with Les.
Oh,
Ooh, that should be a fun show.
Oh, dear, dear. I warned her. She said, I can handle it. And don't you worry.
She can handle anything.
Yeah.
She's got this covered.
Yeah, she really does.
I kind of like that.
What?
That she has it covered.
She does. She's like, don't worry about it. I can handle it. I'm like, okay. He's a jokester. He says things. She's like, nope, don't worry about it. I got it.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yes, it is. She may tell him things he won't like. You never know.
You know, I always wonder about that, but she did say she needs to be invited in
yes.
to share.
Yes.
So you know when you go to the doctor, you've got all these HIPAA violations that you can't cross, you can't say things. So yeah. I always think when she's on the air, I guess you have to say, please share, or we're broadcasting nationally, internationally on the internet yet.
Yeah, uh-huh.
What's she going to say?
You never know.
What do you think she's going to say?
She needs like a disclaimer. Yes, you can share.
What do you think she's going to say?
You know, people call in. But I guess if you're calling in, you're giving the right of, yes, please share my story on air.
You're relinquishing, yes.
Well, let me ask you a question. When she's here, are we going to be allowed to take calls?
It's up to her.
Why would not? We took calls the last time.
I mean, she does her show right from that very chair that Dawn's sitting in. Why not?
Because I want everybody to call in. All right, I'm going to put your son's picture up. You ready?
Aaron, are you ready? If you're still listening, your right, picture is going
his
up.
His son is there. The force is...
is strong.
Strong. What kind of shoes is he wearing?
Ooh, I don't know what shoes those are.
What is that?
Oh,
he looks like a Jedi. He really does.
He looks like a Jedi.
I need to see it later.
You see it?
I can't believe this hour's almost over. That's crazy.
I know, right?
It's crazy. I like when it's just the three of us. I like
we needed
three.
A catch-up show.
We do.
Right?
I like when
yes,
it's three.
I like catch-up.
I know you do.
So the next thing we're going to work on with you and your catch-up is reading the label to look at
how much high fructose
corn syrup is in that ketchup.
Oh, let me tell you, I definitely cannot have McDonald's anymore because I was suffering last night with a stomach ache. I'm pretty sure I do have the
bug?
The celiac disease.
I don't know what that is, but is it contagious?
It's a gluten.
It's a gluten thing.
So don't eat any gluten. Why don't you make me take you to McDonald's if you can't eat
You're that? The one that asked me, do you want to go to McDonald's? And I said,
no. I asked you what you wanted to eat, and you said anything. I says, what does anything mean? You got to give me a more defined statement.
I said, I like sushi. I like salads. I'll eat anything.
Well, we weren't going to stop for sushi. We were late.
We could have gone to Publix for some sushi. What? Or Whole Foods. They have really good sushi there.
Where'd you get that chocolate bar, by the way, last night?
Whole Foods.
That was good.
How'd you get that?
I haven't. I always have chocolate on me in my purse.
Then she says, I need a giant coffee or some other
crazy. She wanted a caramel frappuccino.
Yes, yeah. I did. But then, yeah. You know, I'm
it's
glad
good
it
thing
didn't.
Your silica was silicating.
I know. I'm glad it didn't do it. I'm glad it didn't happen because the stomach ache I dealt with last night was enough. It was bad.
You were bad?
Yeah, it's the gluten thing. I can't do it anymore.
And can't eat no more burgers.
No, it's like the fries, especially in the bread and all that.
You ate the fries too?
Yeah, of course I ate them. You saw me.
I had five fries and Dawn came. Did you see how quickly I was trying to eat those French fries before she got there?
How did I pull up right behind you guys?
Oh,
was
God.
That the craziest
I
thing?
I felt so ratted out since she's going to
see
me eating French
fries. But he tricked me because I said, I'll eat if you eat. If you want to eat there, I'll eat there. Okay, yeah, all right, he says. And then
we were late.
He's like the dad overseeing us to make sure we eat.
Yeah.
That's not true. You came behind me, and I was stuffing...
Yes, I saw that.
I was stuffing the French fries.
And before all this, he was like,
I put it down.
Don't let Dawn know that we got McDonald's. I'm like, oh, okay.
Meanwhile, I have him under my face.
In his hand.
In my hand.
Pulling the French fries out.
And then, did he tell you he got hacked from that trip to McDonald's?
Really? That's where you got hacked? They got your card?
$300.
I keep telling you to take cash.
You know, I don't understand how it happened. There had to be somebody in the car with a, whatchamacallit machine.
A skimmer. That's the new thing.
They picked up a skimmer. I got a thing at one of the gas stations in Palm Beach County yesterday.
I keep getting those in my push notifications.
That's it?
It's a lot. Gas stations are finding a lot of gas.
Yeah, but this
stations.
Wasn't even a gas station. I went to McDonald's.
I know. That's what's scary.
McDonald's.
You can't even go to McDonald's now.
Can't even go to McDonald's.
Can't do nothing.
Can't do nothing.
Big Brother's watching everywhere.
Very
what we got to do is we got to get fast food from somewhere else. We got to go to Publix and say, is your scanner safe?
Do you have a skimmer? We have no skimmers here.
And we get your sushi. We had no time. You know, there's never enough time in the day. And then I had to leave you because I had another show at the other station,
yes,
right?
Yes, Steve-O.
So I set that all up to go back. And then coming back to 2nd Avenue, to Clive Daniels, I forgot where it was.
This 20th and whatever or that other.
It was you got to go down Palmetto.
I had to go home and get bocafied.
And you did a lovely job.
Thank you.
You did a lovely job wearing a ribbon in your hair.
Ribbon wrapped around my body.
We have close to 3 minutes, by the way.
But let me ask you a question. At this event,
yes.
Nobody gets dressed.
What do you mean no one gets? Everyone was dressed to the nines.
Yeah, but I'm saying there's no clothes. Everybody had nothing but short and shorter. It's like, let's see who could wear the shortest dress.
Exactly. Right? That's the whole thing.
Which is fine until you sit on the couch. And then you sit on the couch and you can't cross your legs because it's a low couch. So you have to kind of sit like a lady with your... All the things
side
we
saddle.
Have to do, the side saddle.
First of all, I asked for a high table. He said no.
Correct. I know.
The guy said, why are you going to ruin the shot with a high table? When you see what they're going to be wearing and dressing and sitting down, you're going to understand why.
Maybe that's why he didn't want the high table. But it all worked out beautifully. But yeah. You both did a beautiful job adjusting the camera to the waist up. Thank you very much, because it was a little, got
that
a little
was funny,
tricky.
Wasn't it?
Yeah. Got a little tricky.
Connecticut had a...
When I went back and watched the tape, I thought, oh, thankfully they did that, because I am aware of what's going on, but you got
to
be a little
Yeah, but
careful.
You sat to the side, because you know some of the other ones were sitting there and, oh, and they're all laughing up a storm. Meanwhile, I'm looking away, I'm saying, Faith, did she sit down?
Okay. Sitting side saddle on the couch.
Minutes. We had 2 minutes.
All right.
This hour went quick.
So what do we have Monday?
What do we
Faith
have Monday?
Washington.
We have Faith Washington coming on Monday. Tuesday, we have Sarah Spiritual. 3 days next week.
In
Tuesday,
a row?
Wednesday, Thursday?
Tuesday, Thursday, Friday.
Oh.
We have Kendra. She just dropped an album next week, I believe she's dropping.
Yeah.
So she'll be here next week with Sarah. Wow. Sarah will be co-hosting with us. So some days we have guests, some days we don't.
We have
Jesse Campo.
Campo
is coming on Friday.
Jesse Campo was just elected for the Latin Grammy Awards. She's flying out for the Latin Grammy.
Was that
the
one who called? Was it Jesse that called? I knew it.
Ooh, we've got Jesse and Sarah in the house on Friday together.
That's the one who called during Sarah's episode. I knew. I had a feeling.
Yes, yes.
It was her.
And she'll be with Kendra on Thursday. Sarah will be with Les on Tuesday.
And she told her that something big was coming.
She did.
She did. That's amazing.
Ooh, I've got...
Ooh, me too.
I've got angel bumps.
Ooh, that's craziness.
He thinks I'm crazy. If you could only see the look I get over here.
I'm not saying nothing. All right, so we got next week.
I just get more and more complicated. Next week's going to be an amazing week. Monday is Halloween. Think about coming in costume.
Listen, if you own a business, we have an open mic. You can come in and do an advertisement. We won't
charge you.
You
can find Freddie on amp2.tv at gmail.com.
That's right.
Freddie at amp2.tv.
And I guess we will see you next week.
It's time to wrap it up. Put your lunch away. Have a fabulous Friday. Be safe. Do not drink and drive this weekend for Halloween. And early voting has started. So
that's
go
right.
out and do your public duty.
And just remember,
and
I'm
don't
on
take
the road.
Pictures in the polling place.
Yes, you go to jail for that. Federal offense in Florida.
Have a beautiful day. Great weekend. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That's about it for today's lunch break with two boys from Brooklyn. You're invited to join the break every day, Monday through Friday at 12 noon. So, if you missed some of the good stuff they served up today, there's more coming next time. Bring your lunch and the boys from Brooklyn will bring the smiles. And it's all live. See you next time. Now, go and enjoy the rest of your day. West Palm Beach, an iHeartRadio station.